Hello, beautiful people, and welcome back to Wine Chat. My name is Emma, and I'm a certified sommelier with a mission to spread wine knowledge and to help you drink better. Sometimes in the world of wine, it's not just about drinking the delicious stuff in your glass. There's a lot more that goes on in the vineyard as well, but sometimes it's not all good. So today we are talking about phylloxera, the pest that tried to take down the wine world. So let's chat about it. Phylloxera, one of the most feared words in the wine world. It's not actually a disease, it's a root louse, and it's super tiny. It's about 1/30th of an inch long. Now what it does is it eats the roots of the vines, which deforms them and allows fungal infections to take hold, ultimately killing them. It's spread from vineyard to vineyard by workers' boots, or naturally if the vineyards are close together. It originated in the USA, where they have a different type of vine to the European Vitis vinifera vine. The American vines are resistant to phylloxera and have evolved to have a natural resistance to the root louse. The roots of the American vines expel a sticky sap that clogs the mouths of the phylloxera when it tries to feed from the vines. There are several different theories as to how phylloxera came to Europe and the rest of the world, but the most common one is that it traveled over from the USA on American vines in about the mid-1800s. Although people have been transporting vines and other plants from the USA to Europe and vice versa for a long time before this, the invention of steamships meant that the journey was quicker, and this allowed the phylloxera to survive the journey. The first known documented instance of phylloxera in Europe was not until 1863 in the Department of Gard in the former province of Languedoc. Winemakers did not notice the root louse, but they did notice all of their vines dying. After this, phylloxera quickly spread throughout France and then the rest of Europe, but it took a few more years before the cause of all these vines dying was determined. From the late 1850s to the mid-1870s, over 40% of France's vineyards were destroyed. By the end of the 1800s, it's estimated that over 2/3 of all of Europe's vineyards were destroyed. The Minister of Agriculture and Commerce in France offered a reward of 320,000 francs to anyone who could find a cure. People started experimenting with all sorts of cures, including poison, flooding the vineyards, changing the soil types, grape alternatives, and even planting a live toad under the vines to try and draw out the poison. A group of researchers eventually discovered that grafting a European vine onto American rootstock that was resistant to phylloxera worked. Although some rootstocks, such as the AXR1, did eventually give in to phylloxera, which means that replanting is still ongoing to this day. There are some vineyards around the world, though, that have remained free of phylloxera. Most of these vineyards will have sandy soils and high winds, which help to deter the root louse. Most Chilean wine has been free of phylloxera due to how it is separated from the rest of the world, with the Atacama Desert to the north, the Pacific Ocean to the west, and the Andes Mountains to the east. In Australia, several regions, including Tasmania and Western Australia, have never had phylloxera. This is mostly thanks to their Vine Protection Act of 1874. The Mosel region in Germany has also remained free of phylloxera as it's unable to survive in the slate soil. The Andesito vineyard in Santa Maria Valley, AVA in California, is free of phylloxera due to the high percentage of sand in the soil. Now this is a top vineyard and it's used by some incredible producers, and all the vines here are planted on their original rootstocks. But these vineyards might not be resistant forever, unfortunately. Bollinger in Champagne had three parcels of ungrafted Pinot Noir vines that were used to make the Bollinger Vieuvrin Francois, a very rare and expensive champagne. Unfortunately, one of the plots fell to phylloxera in 2004, meaning that it had to be replanted. Today, there is still no remedy for phylloxera, and it will consistently threaten any vineyard that is not grafted onto American rootstock. Some producers will keep their original vines until they absolutely have to replant them, as phylloxera lowers the yields of vines and helps to contribute to a noticeable concentration of the fruit. For example, Hirsch Vineyards in Sonoma Coast has some phylloxera affected vines in their East Ridge Vineyard, which helps to make one of their most age-worthy wines. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to give this video a like, share it with someone who you think needs to know about phylloxera, and remember to subscribe for some more wine education. Until next time, remember, drink better, be better.